for the first time and...
Really?
You weren't falling?
Really.
He goes right to the top and right down.
And he doesn't
no falling? No.
Yeah, he went down a couple of black diamonds.
Yeah, our fall.
Yeah. And we want to see your strawberry though.
Yeah, show us your strawberry, Christian.
But I remember my first day snowboarding.
You took a lesson?
Yeah, I thought.
I guess I'll start by saying.
Okay, Kevin's gonna talk.
We do, but it throws us off too.
This boy is different, much more mature than I was at this age. In fact, it took me about twice his age, even maybe near. I wanted to say first. That we should,
she didn't do anything wrong.
10 seconds to appreciate our mom and our dad, and I would clap at the dog will bark. So, just after, look at all of us. We've been around for a little bit, and I just want to say how much I appreciate mom and dad, and I'm sure that we all appreciate Jeb and Wendy, and how much through having children. You can appreciate having parents.
Yes.
Because you learn how tough it is. Anyway, we're in Hawaii, which on Oahu again, where we started when we went there. We spent 12 years on the Big Island. And we love it there, but circumstances brought us back to Oahu. And it's very expensive there. Comparable to say here, I think. Although the grocery prices look fantastic here. I'm still working at Pearl Harbor Naval Shipyard Help Desk as the lead and hoping to get into a systems administrator position. Although, well, I am somewhat of a systems administrator already. I would come back here if the price was right, I guess. We are active in a church on Oahu called New Hope Christian Fellowship, which we love and we spend quite a bit of time with, and I thought we were going to be empty nesters in another few years, but we're starting again with a little 2.5-year-old, and he's the joy of my life. We have a lot of problems with, if you think kids are problems at what ages?
14 to 16.
Just wait.
Yeah.
God bless you. And Noah is, let's see, Lauriana is 16. Noah's 14.
Mommy.
And Luke is, let's see, wondering where we are. He doesn't understand. He's 2, and we talked to him on the phone, and he... He doesn't know where we are. Anyway, I think a lot of you have probably been to Hawaii once or twice, but if you come again, please stop and sleep in one of the bedrooms or on the couch or on the floor. And we'd love to see you. And it's kind of tough when I'm working to get away, but I'm in a situation where I can kind of break away sometimes. Liz is, she was doing some...
No, I'm going to come out there next weekend.
Yeah, I'm going to see us.
Are you?
Yeah.
I just decided.
2 days.
No,
I don't think I'll see much of him. Can I tell him the last time he came?
Sure.
He called me and said, I'm here. And then I spent an hour with him running his rental car back to the rental car place and running him to the airport. That's all I got to see him. So I hope we get to see a little more of him, although when you're in Hawaii, it's nice to surf, so I'll understand if he wants to go ride some waves. But you better be careful because at this time of the year, they're dangerous. They're dangerously big. But he knows that too, because the last time I think he experienced some death, literally death-defying waves. So.
Yeah.
You hit the coral a few times, didn't you?
Mm-hmm. It gets scary.
It broke the board in half. You're kidding me.
And he gets the
clean half.
Anyway, what else is there to say? We love the Lord, and oh, I learned a very important. I relearned a very important lesson the other night. Mom showed Merlin Carruthers' Prison of Praise on TV, and oh, I should tell this story. It's very good. Sometimes something happens in your life, and you don't really know or understand the reason why. And we've all had a number of those things happen in our lives. This message was to praise, I think the most outstanding part of the whole message was to praise God in all things. Even when you're facing very difficult things in your life. And it's very easy to imagine yourself praising Him when it's tough. But it's another thing when you're actually faced with something tough. That night, when I went to bed, I went to sleep. I was woken up because I left my cell phone turned up. And then before I made it back to sleep, I remembered, and I'm sure all of you can identify with this, that very sick feeling you have inside when you remember that, oh my God, I'm in San Clemente and I left my wallet at Big Bear. And then it came to me, I need to praise God, even though I just didn't know what to do. You know, and everybody was asleep, and I thought, I need my ID to get on the plane to go home, and am I going to make it back to Big Bear? And that's it seems like a pretty long way away. And is it actually even where I think it is? So I just said, Dear Lord, praise you. Praise you for this. I really don't feel like praising you right now. I feel terrible, but praise you.
I got ready, Mama.
And it all worked out. We drove up to Big Bear. When was that?
Well,
yeah,
the
day before yesterday.
Well, we were facing that storm coming, so they had to get up there.
Well,
that
Thursday, thing. I think.
Was it where you left it?
It was right where I left it.
Sunday.
And you went skiing, got the best snow this season.
He would like to.
We weren't going to tell you that.
Got fresh powder.
Did you?
It was a blast to be on the slopes again. It's been over 20 years. The last time I'd skied, there was no such thing as a snowboard. I was really worried about my knee because I've had surgery. I had torn meniscus. I thought I would injure my knee permanently or, you know, be disabled. And we were right back out on the slopes, and it came right back like that. And it taught me that I can still do it. And it was just a blast. And I didn't get to see Mom and Dad back out there, but it was just a lot of fun. And it was a good fellowship in the evening.
On an 18th century box. That and the lack of presence of a mark on the base doesn't necessarily mean it wasn't in the palace. But it does probably...
Christian, welcome to Las Cruces, New Mexico. You did a good job driving today. Lenny did a good job driving. And Doggy did a good job being a good passenger. Are you hungry? Did you want to share some of that with me? I don't think she wants to share that with me. We've had quite a day driving from San Clemente, California to New Mexico. So Lenny's watching one of her favorite shows, The Antique Show. Christian's trying to synchronize his phone to... What are you trying to do with your phone? He's looking for a registration code. That's his bed.